Volvo is going all electric. Is that true? This small video, a comment and discussion video with me, with Thomas from Autogefühl, about the Volvo electrification strategy. Because maybe you have read the headlines these days, and there were headlines like, no more combustion engines at Volvo. So in German, keine Verbrennungsmotoren mehr. So just all pure electric and Volvo, so clean, so great, everything. And that was actually not meant, but then others said, ah, it's, you know, it's just a PR gag, so a PR scoop, actually. So what is it now? Is Volvo really going all electric? Or was it just, you know, a fake? Was it a PR scoop? I think it's something in between, and let me explain why. First of all, what is Volvo really doing? By the year 2019, all new vehicles that are sold there, they say they do not want any vehicle without an electric part. And that will include, first of all, pure electric vehicles, but not so many. Then a lot of hybrid vehicles, already with the XC90 or with the XC60, the all new model standing behind us. If you haven't watched the full review, tune into that, of course. Also available as a T8 hybrid. And then the so-called mild hybrids. And those ones will have the biggest percentage share in the next years. What is a mild hybrid? Yes, there are some electrical parts there on 48 volt basis, but that's, you know, not something new. BMW has been using that even in the 3 Series though for a lot of years. And the thing is about that, well, yes, there is some regenerative braking that you can recuperate some energy. And for example, this is used for the normal internal battery, or for example, as a little assist when the car is about to start, for example. So yes, it has some electrification, but the main engine is still a combustion engine. It's not a big game changer. It can save a little bit of fuel, but maybe just a little bit. So when the headline says no more combustion engines at Volvo, that's just not true. However, is it just a PR scoop? Well, I mean, they could have put the headline a little bit differently. Then again, maybe they wouldn't have had such an impact. But what I think is the most important part, yes, they will also use a lot of those mild hybrids, and it will take some more time until they're all electric or until the plug-in hybrid share will raise even more. I think the most important point is the commitment. And Volvo does show that. I mean, there's Tesla with the all-electric vehicles, but then what's there? Which other brand, which is already on the market for years, which brand is really committing to something to that extent? And Volvo really says, I mean, even if we don't have all electric vehicles in next years, we are really committed to this technology. They will at some point then also stop developing the combustion engines any further. First of all, stopping with the diesel for the passenger cars, and more electric part and electric share will be introduced. And I think this commitment is really important. On the one end there, for example, I mean, yeah, if you hear something like that, you might know why. And they basically ignore the CNG technology, so compressed natural gas, whereas some other manufacturers are going for that one at the moment. So I'm not sure. CNG is also a pretty good midterm solution, for sure. But Volvo also has to see, you know, they don't have too much budget. That's also the reason why they concentrated on those 2-liter displacement four-cylinder engines. We just put this engine block this size so we can put the cost way down. Mercedes or BMW can, you know, 4-cylinder, 6-cylinder, 8-cylinder, they have more budget to produce different sizes of engine. And then it also makes sense if you put the electrification inside there to, you know, increase the electrification stage one by one. So yes, on the one hand, it was a little bit of a PR scoop. Then there were also false headlines. But in the end, I think what counts is that the commitment for, you know, a new form of drivetrains, I think that's the real good part in it. Thank you. This is my opinion. And of course, put yours in the comments. What do you think in general about the Volvo strategy for electrification? What do you think about this concise issue we had there, about the different opinions, and also what the other manufacturers are doing? Let's discuss it on the comments, because this is also really enriching for us if we get your feedback, man, if we get your feedback on this issue, of course. So let's start the discussion. Let's see who wins in the battle of opinions. Of course, vote also on the comments if you think one is especially good. I'm really looking forward. What's your take on this whole issue? Thanks.